Welcome back to the Macon Coliseum in the Georgia High School Association State Basketball Finals, presented by Breda Pest Management, the official sponsor of high school basketball. Taking center stage, it's the 4A state championship game as the Fayette County Tigers take on the Pace Academy Knights. And good evening, I'm Matt Stewart, joined by former McDonald's All-American and Georgia Bulldog Sean Golden. And Sean, Pace Academy going for their fifth all-time state championship. Coach Sharm White going for his 10th, while Fayette County and Coach Andre Flynn back in the state finals for the fourth time in his 22-year career, looking for his first state crown. But we've got a game of contrasting styles here in this one.
Well, you talk about the coaches first. I mean, these guys are veterans around the game. They know how to win, and especially Coach White going for his 10th. But you talk about the contrast in styles. Fayette County, they want to come out like the hare. They want to run fast. It's like fast, 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 the fast and the furious. Pace at the same time, they want to control the pace. They want to slow it down, control and manage the game.
Well, let's talk about the Pace Academy Knights. They are led by their four-star junior, Kyle Green, rated as high as the number 16 point guard in the country, has 20-plus offers.
He's one of those players that controls the game, has great IQ. He's a pure point guard. He's the floor general. He's got to be able to set the tone early in the game so that Pace can actually play at the style of play that want.
For Fayette County, Coach Flynn says this is a little bit of a surprise team for them to get to the finals. They are led by R.J. Kennedy, who averages 24 points per game.
Well, he talked about being a surprise team because he didn't know his team. And now you come out here, you got a chance to win a championship tonight. And Kennedy averaging 24 points a game. He's a team leader. He's a scorer. He can erupt for 40 points. So he may put up some big numbers tonight and has to in order for this Fayette County team to cut down the nets.
Yeah. Kennedy was with them 2 years ago when they got to the state finals, but he is surrounded by three sophomores and a guy who didn't play last year. As you take a look at that starting lineup for the Tigers, McAllister, Hurst, Gillespie, Van Dorn, and the aforementioned Kennedy. And for the Pace Academy Knights, they've got the size advantage in this game as well. You go Green, Chatfield, who's actually their leading scorer, Bing Evans, and LJ Moore.
Well, talking to both coaches, Fayette County, they got to come out here and defend by limiting rebounds, run the tempo, Pace Academy, attack the rim, be the hunter and not be hunted, slow the ball in transition, and control the rhythm of the game.
Pace Academy at 24-7 on the season, as you heard John mention a few moments before we got started. Played an international schedule, played all over the world, played in London against some top national competition. Fayette County at 26-5 on the season. They have a 13-game winning streak since their last loss to county rival Sandy Creek, who we'll see playing here this week in the 3A state championship game.
With his pace again, got the high post offense, the down screen, they got motion, they got movement. Just running their action to get a good shot.
Intercepted, ball kicks around in the paint. And Fayette County has it and brings it back the other way. Fayette County averaging 76.4 points per game, and that's Christian McAllister with the first bucket.
Well, the beautiful thing there was how the trap came, but offensively they passed out of the trap. A lot of times you beat the trap half court or full court with the pass and not the dribble. Good offensive play.
Last touch by Fayette County. It'll be Pace Academy's ball underneath.
And that was just great basketball there from McAllister, just seeing the basketball, understanding the floor, great court awareness in that half-court set.
Sharman White, 125-27 his record at Pace Academy. He's won two state titles with Pace Academy. He won seven at Miller Grove, a program that he built from scratch. Pace Academy situation been a little bit different. But he says the commonality, Sean, is with Miller County, or Miller Grove, I should say, and Pace is that, you know, you implement the same thing. It's all about habits and fundamentals.
And I've been knowing Coach White for a long time. There's two words I describe to him. He's humble yet hungry. And that's a rare combination when you're finding a coach that wins at the level that he does.
You saw Andre Flynn just a few moments ago, 500 and One career wins in his 22 seasons. Wing three off the mark, offensive rebound, and put back for the Tigers.
And we talked about attack mode. That's Fayette County. It's like the turtle and the hare. They're getting down the court. Pace has to control them in transition, eliminate second chance and easy baskets.
And we'll have a traveling call on Pace Academy.
The most consistent thing we'll talk about all week long is the first 4 minutes. That's where the pace is being set, how both teams want to play. Let's see which pace actually can evolve to the top, whether it's a slower control pace or it's a fast and the furious pace.
Well, you mentioned the different paces, and certainly that's reflected in their points per game average. Pace Academy averaging 65.9 a game. Fayette County averaging, as I mentioned before, 76.4.
Well, you see Pace here with a full court pressure. It's always been told, teams that press do not like to be pressed. So we'll see, this is one of those coaching moments. Coach White kind of pulls some tricks out the bag here at the beginning of the game.
Sharman White with 498 career victories in 25 seasons as a head coach. Also very much involved with USA Basketball, last summer coaching the national under 17 team. And before that, coached the under 16 team.
Well, he's definitely been around a lot of top coaches, from Coach K to Tubby Smith to Jim Boeheim. So he's inherited and seen coaching at the highest level.
LJ Moore called the foul on Pace Academy. Tigers off to a 4-0 lead here. Double team and a tie-up, jump ball. Possession arrow favors Pace, so they get it back.
And here's Pace doing something. You know, we talk about the press in the full court and the half court. They're kind of picking up the tempo on the defensive end and playing more controlled on the offensive end.
Looking to go low block with it. Got single coverage, the jump hook and the turnaround. And offensive rebound and miss. We'll have a foul called on Fayette County.
Great action on the baseline with the baseline screen and getting the ball to Moore, just a versatile player. And, you know, whenever you can get the ball inside to your aggressive, versatile players inside, second chance scoring opportunities and present themselves at a good click.
Foul's called on Van Dorn. That'll be the first on him. And that'll put Lamar L.J. Moore at the line. He's been offered by Kennesaw State and also receiving interest from Mercer and Illinois State.
Well, he's one of those players that you want on your team. First of all, he's part of a winning program. So players that come out of winning programs know how to prepare. They know how to practice. And that's important when you go to the next level.
He's been a big glue guy for them this season. And a 62% free throw shooter, missed the second one. Corner three. Nailed it.
And that was great penetration there in transition by Fayette County. Not going too deep. Hitting the open shooter in the corner.
That was Keith Gillespie on the other end with his 92nd three-point basket of the season. Step back, thrown away, run out opportunity for the Knights. And one.
That was a big time finish. Big time finish. You know, here's Green in transition. And you can tell he's young. I mean, he's long. He's got a good size. And the one thing, when it gets to the next level, you got to eliminate a couple of those dribbles and get to the basket faster. Even though he got the and one, but when he grows, that's maybe a two-dribble drive to the basket to get you an and one.
Kyle Green completes the three-point play. Green's highest-ranking ESPN four-star, number seven-ranked junior prospect in the state of Georgia. A timeout has been called on the floor. We'll step aside with him. 4:46 to play in the opening quarter. Fayette County on top by a point.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your face got me feeling some kind of way.
In the blink of an eye,
so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
In lively towns and peaceful rural areas, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives are on a mission to provide a different kind of electricity. Our not-for-profit, member-owned EMCs are focused on making life better for members. At private residences, farms, and thriving businesses, we work for you. Generating safe, reliable, affordable electricity, giving back to local programs, serving our members to make life brighter. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Fayette County jumped out to a 7-1 lead in this game. Pace Academy has scored the last five. Matt Stewart along with Sean Golden. Tigers in the midst of a 13-game winning streak coming into the state final. Their last loss to Sandy Creek, 82-61. And that's a loss that Coach Flynn told us, Sean, really helped his team.
Yeah, you're right. It's the rivalry. It's right down the street. Even it starts in middle school because both middle school teams had to play each other, and that's what he's filled with underclassmen. So Sandy Creek has really helped them prepare, not just for this game, but just getting better throughout the season.
Lost twice to the Fighting Patriots during the regular season. And Sandy Creek will be playing Cedar Grove in the 3A state final. Might recognize that matchup. That was the same matchup in the football state championship. The drive, shot rejected at the rim. Pace retains control. The flip up and in. Nicely done. Great body control.
And it all starts with them playing more under control, but more importantly, Green just handling the pressure and making wise, smart decisions. Not trying to make the big play, but just getting singles and singles, and the singles will add up to doubles.
Moore has scored five of their first 8 points in this game. Averages 9.5, so L.J. Moore off to a great start here tonight.
You talk about Pace Academy, they came out the gate with two quick turnovers, but since then, they've played better. And it started on the defense. Now, Coach White then implemented full-court pressure, half-court pressure, and decided we're going to increase or control the tempo with our defense against these Fayetteville Tigers. So that's good coaching, and now the players are starting to adjust to the tempo of the game.
R.J. Kennedy at the line, completes them both. 69% free throw shooter, but he will get to the line a lot. He's got a three-level game. He can score at the rim. He can score mid-range. He can hit the three-point shot.
Yeah, Coach talked about him. He's an outstanding scorer, an outstanding player, but his biggest strength this season has been his leadership. I mean, his leadership. He wants everyone to follow his lead, and that's what you do when you're the top player. Be the top player, not just on the court, off the court as well.
Family moved in from Oklahoma to the Fayetteville area. Joined the team in the sophomore season. That was a state final season for Fayette County. They're in the state finals for the third time in 5 years. Turnaround jumper. And rebound controlled by the Knights. Kyle Green, who's a true point guard, stops and pops.
Hey, listen, Matt, that's big time. I'm telling you, under control, behind the back, great balance, but a pull-up shot in transition. Most point guards want to get to the rim. He attacks it and pulls up a wide-open half-percent shot in transition. Fantastic job.
Three-point shot off the mark of the rebound controlled by Kendall Evans, who's signed with Navy to play football. Pace up a point. Dribble drive, kick out, wing three, air ball. Saved by Pace in the corner. And we'll have a foul called on Pace. That'll be an offensive foul. That's going against Eric Chatfield, who's their leading scorer at 12.4 points per game, but has not scored in this game.
Both coaches have their teams prepared. Hey, guys, each team's going to give you their best early, but we're going to both play our game And it's just a solid, balanced game right now. Just 9-10 by Pace Academy, but everyone's playing a lot more under control with a lot of poise.
Well, this is the thing that Pace wants to do. They want to keep Fayette County out of transition. And they'd like to do that with made buckets. That's the number one goal. Foul called on Pace. Davis Rice is called for the foul. And that's going to be the third team foul on Pace. Sean Van Dorn at the line. Van Dorn, a 64% free throw shooter and second leading scorer on this team at 15.3 a game. Also averages 8 rebounds per game. 6'5 sophomore.
Yeah, he's a nice looking player. Good scorer, good rebounder, slasher, driver, kind of does it all. And he's going to have a bright future in this program.
10-10, and we're going to have a foul called on Fayette County. That was Van Dorn. No, that was not Van Dorn.
I'm very impressed here early with Green. The reason why, because he has great body control and knows how to protect the ball against the defense. I really like his style of play.
E.G. Woye was called for that foul. Nice move and get to the rim.
And see, when a guy that long and that size knows how to use his body, and he's very young, so... You know, when Coach White talked about his IQ, he's showing his knowledge of the game, and it's just his thirst to get better, which is going to make him improve down the road.
Kyle Green, 6'4", 170, junior. Shot was blocked. Baseball pass ahead. Cross court. Pull-up jumper. Missed the floater. Rice did, and Fayette County's got it. Wing three. Gets his own miss. Ball poked from behind, but a foul is going to be called on Moore. That'll be the second personal foul on L.J. Moore.
Well, you know, a minute 43 now to go, and I'm sure fatigue is starting to kick in on both teams, and you see some subs coming in here quickly, getting ready for the first quarter timeout. But, you know, I just love it. This is a really good game to watch.
MJ Madison was actually called for the foul on that possession and not Moore. Baseline jumper, Van Dorn. Game tied at 12. Good pace, no pun intended. The runner, rim out. Van Dorn clears the rebound. Travel. Christian McAllister shuffled his feet before he put the ball on the floor.
And that happens a lot of time when you're trying to score in transition. That left foot sometimes drags, and it does happen, but that was a great decision to shot fake and try to get to the rim. He just moved, shuffled his feet very slightly for the official to call the travel.
Blocked by Van Dorn. But they stick with it and stick it in. Moore was tenacious.
He's relentless out there. Just playing relentless. He knows he has to be at his best game tonight for them to win, and so he's showing how to cut, move, and score while attacking the rim.
Davis Rice is called for the foul. That'll be number two on him. So the team fouls racking up here on Pace. They already have five.
Well, now
six, pardon me.
And well, think about this. We talked about the pace of the game. You know, sometimes when you're playing faster than what you're normally playing, fouls accumulate, because the offense is going faster and the defense now has to adjust. So fouls do happen when you play faster than what you're accustomed to playing.
Christian McAllister is a 73% free throw shooter. One more to tie the game. Rebound cleared by Evans. Underneath. And that's Jackson Ferry, the son of the former Duke star and NBA general manager Danny Ferry.
And that was great basketball, great ball movement. The ball didn't hit the floor. It went high side, low side, and it's hit the first open player and the finish at the rim. Great job, great finish by Ferry.
3-point lead for Pace. Underneath and one. E.G. Woye with the basket.
And you see what Fayette County is doing. They're not letting pace get set up in their defense. They're attacking in transition. The ball is moving side, top side. The defense is not comfortable playing at this pace. So now Fayette County, they're not just getting to the rim and scoring. They're getting three-point baskets, and they're getting fouls on Pace Academy.
Madison picks up his second personal foul. And Chandler Bean checks in as Madison goes to the bench. And Pace Academy is already over the limit. Fayette County shooting bonus. 26 seconds to play in the quarter.
One shot game. Shot clock situation is off.
10 seconds, got to put the offense in motion here. High ball screen, goes back to Ferry, misses the three-point attempt badly. Follow, and again misses badly at the buzzer. And we are tied at 16 after one quarter of play. So a good, clean first quarter, 41% shooting for Pace, 50% for Fayette County. 32 total points, split evenly.
It's time to reveal what I'm doing after graduation. We got my cupcakes and we got my schools. Let's just do it. Cupcakes aren't really my thing, and neither is going to a four-year college. Instead, I'm getting paid $18 an hour to train as a commercial plumber. There's a ton of other trades, like electrical and carpentry, where you can make great money, live a great lifestyle with little to no debt, and even be your own boss.
Let me know if I can help you with anything.
Just looking. I only buy local and sustainable, so.
Oh, well, that shirt's not local. You should be wearing cotton. Georgia's a major supplier of cotton worldwide, so if you'd like to buy local to support Georgia, buying cotton's a great place to start. It's renewable and sustainable, naturally.
Thanks.
That's a polyester fiber made of oil, by the way.
Where's your dressing room?
DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
Start of the second quarter at the Macon Coliseum, the 4A state championship game. Fayette County and Pace Academy tied at 16. Matt Stewart along with Sean Golden. And Sean, we talked a lot about who controls the pace, and again, no pun intended. Who do you felt the first quarter, who do you think won the first quarter?
Well, I'm going to say it's Fayette County, and here's the reason why. It's not the score, even though it's 16-16, it's the fouls. I mean, Pace Academy, they have 7 fouls, they're in the bonus, and it's 7-3, so the advantage goes to Fayette County, because now when it's 7-3 with the fouls, you're putting Pace Academy in a position they're not accustomed to playing.
Fayette County will be shooting the bonus for the entire second quarter, and that's going to be team foul number 8.
And they're attacking the rim. They're scoring in transition. They're moving the ball. They're taking advantage of their size and their strength. And that's basically starting to weigh on Pace Academy here in the second quarter.
Robert Hurst at the line, a 62% free throw shooter, and he shoots Fayette County back into the lead. Fayette County is already 6 of 8 at the foul line in this game. Make it 7 of 9 at the foul line. Pace is 2 of 3.
And let me share this tidbit with you. When you attempt more free throws than your opponents make, the odds that you win the game are very high.
And we'll have a foul called on Fayette County. Looks like number 12, Van Dorn, is going to be called, and that's going to be number 2 on him, and that'll be the 4th team foul on the Tigers. E.G. Woje comes in for him. ...18-16, Fayette County on top. Been runners-up in the state finals 2008, 2019, and 2021. They've made the playoffs all 22 years of Coach Andre Flynn's career.
Well, he's a dynamic coach. And the one thing that I love about him, he's very passionate about his players. You know, he really pays attention to detail, not just on the court, off the court, in the classroom, in their lives. And when your players feel that love from you, they'll do anything they can to help not just the team, but everyone around them succeed.
Foul was called on Isaiah Franklin. Inbounds comes to Pace in the paint, up and in.
Big time move, big time move, big time basket. Much needed there for Pace to get this back to a tie game.
LJ Moore now in double figures. He has 11 of their 20 points. 11 of their 18, pardon me. We're tied at 18. I think I jumped the gun on that. He's got 9 points, not 11.
Well, this is what he does. He's versatile. And when you got a guy like that that's versatile, can score not just inside and outside, he's very valuable to the team and what they're trying to accomplish.
Well, you asked each coach about MVPs and MIPs, most important players, and LJ Moore was that MIP for the Knights. Foul's going to be called on Kendall Evans.
And let me explain that, Matt. What people got to understand, the MVP is the one that everyone talks about. He gets all the accolades, but the MIP, they have more intangibles, things you do not see that's on the stat sheet, things you do not see behind closed doors. They do the little things that help you succeed, and that's exactly what he brings to the table.
E.G. Woye hits the free throw, and Pace is going to be in trouble if Fayette County keeps shooting free throws like this. They're 8 for 11 so far in this game. Inside they go, shot rejected, foul called on Robert Hurst.
And that's a credit to Coach White. That's a set play, block-to-block screen, on the switch. Let's go high-low basketball, isolate our big guy down low, and that's Moore doing what he does, attacking the rim with a dribble drop step, now going to the free throw line for a chance to knock down two.
Moore has had a strong game, 9 points and three rebounds so far. Hits the free throw.
And that's what Coach White does. He isolates his players in the position for them to succeed. LJ Moore, he has a mismatch on the block. Let's get him isolated so they can go down there and go to work.
Yeah, Coach Sharm White says that Moore is just so smart. He knows what the coaches are going to say before it comes out of their mouths.
And you need players like that to win at any level, whether it's high school, whether it's college or professional. You have to have one of those two players that actually can be a coach on the floor.
Right there in the paint, Kennedy misses the shot. Pace comes down the floor, up one. Moore, what a move.
Wow, that was a big time move. Transition basket, way able to cover with the crossover there and attacking the rim. He's showing us a lot of good things this afternoon.
A lot of stuff in his bag. I tell you what, he's showing a big skill set here.
But see, here's the one thing that I love about that play. It started with the pass, the advance up the court, that screen. Let's see my best player up the court. Let's get him the ball in open floor so he can attack instead of dribbling up the court. And that's what a good point guard does. You don't dribble the entire time. You advance the basketball. The ball is faster on the pass than the dribble.
Chatfield was called for the foul. That's two on him. And Rice comes into the game for the Knights. And Fayette County just eating things up at the foul line. Does get the, oh, and they got the tip in on the offensive glass. Nearly half of their points have come at the free throw line. 9 of their 21. Scoop shot, nicely done.
Hey, man, he is smooth as ice. I mean, this young kid.
Try stopping
play.
That, yeah.
I mean, it's hard to defend. He's long. He's got great body. He knows when to attack, when not to attack. He's nice, and he's going to be a very good player down the road.
Nicely done. Great recognition on that offensive set to find the open guy right there in the middle of the paint, E.G. Woye. Game tied at 24. Foul called on Fayette County. Hurst is whistled. Watch Kyle Green. He's got 20-plus offers, including South Carolina, Clemson, Georgetown, Dayton, Ole Miss, and Pitt.
Old-school player with the scoop. I mean, man, that's big-time basketball. And as he gets bigger, faster, and stronger, and understands the game a little bit more, he'll be able to do a lot, especially when he gets to the next level.
Rated as high as the number 16 point guard in the nation in the junior class. Coach Sharm White says he just understands the game at a different level. Inside, and Moore just continues to feed underneath.
Well, the set plays, understand what Pace is doing. They're running action. They're running the set plays. They're running curls to get some easier baskets than forcing it with the dribble or the drive.
Foul's going to be called on Pace again. They are 10-plus team fouls now. Bing picks up his second. They now have four players with two personal fouls. And we're not even halfway through the second quarter yet. Long outlet comes to Rice. Rice drives on through and missed the layup. Moore gets the offensive rebound and sticks it in.
Man, he is that workhorse. He is that guy, that glue guy we talked about, the MIP. You need him on the court. You need him in the locker room. You need him to win a championship.
What a first half performance by L.J. Moore. 7 points in this quarter alone and 15 total. Inside the bucket. Ejiwoye is coming off the bench, didn't start, and he's really given them a spark.
Yeah, he's one of those role players that when your time is called, your name is called, you need to deliver, and he's definitely doing a great job here in the second quarter.
22 of Pace's 28 points in the paint. Good luck getting in front of Kyle Green.
He's very smooth. He's very under control and just attacks. When the window is open, he attacks. When not, he moves the ball and reverses the ball.
And we have an offensive foul called on Fayette County. That'll go against Robert Hurst. And a timeout on the floor. 30-26, Pace Academy. L.J. Moore having himself a finals. 17 of the Knights, 30 points.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your face, got me feeling some kind of way.
Blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Today's conservation-minded consumer cares about where their energy comes from. Your local EMC cares, too. Georgia's electric membership cooperatives offer renewable options for our members. In fact, our solar portfolio will produce enough clean energy to power more than 180,000 households. Striving to move the needle toward progress and position communities for the future. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Coach Sharm White told us he has such a balanced team. You're not going to see many 20-point games from his guys, but L.J. Moore has 17 points in the first half. Kyle Green has 11. Those two have combined for 28 of their 30 points, Sean.
Well, you're trying to win a championship. And when you want to win a championship, it's not about having a balanced attack. I need my players to step up. These are the two horses on the team. Guys, we're going to ride you guys to cut down nets.
Well, L.J. Moore, as I mentioned, has been offered by Kennesaw State, getting interest from Mercer in Illinois State. I think that interest meter is going to peak even more given this state championship performance. And Green gets in there, and when he gets in the paint, and he's got so many moves, he's impossible to stop.
Well, he knows how to use his body. There was a hesitation dribble to see what the defense was going to give him, and then he exploded. He's long, a little lanky, and he got to the rim off one dribble. That's great basketball on his behalf.
He's got 13 points now, and we will have a foul. Looks like it's going to be called on Pace. So now we have three personal fouls on Rice. He's the first guy to reach that number. And he's done it in 6 minutes.
Well, he's one of those guys. Hey, it's not about you coming in and scoring. Let's give one of our top players a little break. Just come and play hard. You get three fouls in the first half, so what? Your job is to give our players some rest and come in here and do some dirty work.
Three-pointer.
Fouls, that's a good thing.
Offensive putback and a foul coming over the back by the defender, and so Pace Academy racks up another foul, and Ichiwoye, who's really kind of been the big offensive spark for Fayette County in this first half, going to the line again.
Got to box out. It's important to play the entire possession. Contest, five guys have to check out, and, you know, that's just being aggressive, getting to the rim, and now there's a chance for Fayette County to knock it down, hit the free throw line.
Christian McAllister at the line. Thought it would be Ichiwoye, but it's McAllister, and he knocks down the free throw.
And we haven't talked about McAllister. I mean, this kid right here is the lead guard of the program. So, you know, he can get to the rim and get some baskets. He can make some things happen.
And we have a traveling call. Kendall Evans took too many steps. 4-point lead, Pace Academy. Shooting 56% from the floor. They're 14 for 25. They've only attempted two threes, have not made one. Fayette County's one of six on their threes and shooting 47%. Van Dorn in the paint. Tipped up and in. Almost looked like Pace Academy might have tipped that in.
Well, Pace Academy in that possession switched to a 2-3 zone, more of a matchup. And the one hardest thing in the zone is to rebound. And they took advantage of that, Fayette County did, and got the tip in.
Pass goes off the backboard, deflected by Fayette County. Chance to tie or take the lead on this possession. Stolen away. Flipped it over his shoulder. It's a race for the loose ball, and it's going to be Fayette County's ball.
And see, that possession alone shows how fatigue can kick in. Pace Academy, that was a ball you had to go and try to save, but just not accustomed to playing at that pace for a consistent half this entire season.
Got to do a better job of valuing the basketball. After you got the steal, there was no need to just flip it blindly over your shoulder. I know he's trying to get the run out and get the fast break. It's a good thought, but when it doesn't work, it's a wasted opportunity. Van Dorn off back iron. Battle for the rebound. Let's see if they call a jump ball. They do. Let's check the possession arrow. It's going to be Pace's ball.
And you hear what I said, you know, that's my guy, Danny Ferry.
Yeah, Danny Ferry in the crowd. You think he's played in a few big basketball games?
I think he has.
And now his son Jackson is, too, playing for the state championship with Pace. Dribble drive, and Chatfield will go to the line. Their leading scorer is still without any points, but he'll go to the line to shoot, too. Foul called on Gillespie. That'll be number one on him.
And one of the things Coach White talked about with Chatfield is we have a two-headed monster at the point guard. It's good to have versatile point guards, and I think Chatfield needs to come in and just give Green a little bit of a break at the point so Green can be fresh going into the second half.
Chatfield's been offered by Georgia State, Coach Jonas Hayes. Kennesaw State, Coach Amir Abdur-Rahim, congratulations to the Owls, A-Sun champions. They're going to the NCAA tournament. He's been offered by Tulane, Coach Ron Hunter.
Well, you got to look at the program these kids play in. You got discipline. You have integrity. There's a lot of intangibles with playing for a guy like Coach White, because when they come to your program at the collegiate level, you don't have to teach them how to practice, how to hold themselves accountable, and you can win because those guys understand the importance of the little things that needs to happen.
Up and in. Fayette County converts underneath. Van Dorn. Inside back the other way. It rolls off the rim. And the putback missed. They kept it alive, and Pace Academy's going to go to the line.
Relentless on the glass. Pace Academy, they're not quitting. They have a lot of heart. And that's what Coach White said. Hey, we've been battle tested. Think of where these guys have gone to. London, Ohio, Tennessee. We've been battle tested with a tough schedule all season long. So these kids know how to compete on a consistency and at the highest level.
Yeah, Pace Academy won the state title in 2020 and 2021. Got knocked out in the second round last year. And Coach Charm White said they were a young team and felt like they weren't battle tested enough during the regular season. And when the playoff intensity came, they weren't quite ready for it. So that's why they embarked on this very ambitious schedule that took them all over the country and across the Atlantic Ocean to play in London. They went 9-1 at home, 9-1 on the road, 6-5 in neutral site games, which of course was all of that national and international competition. Pace up by five.
And what Green just did there shows me he has great court savvy, knows where the defense is, knows where his teammates are, and made a great pass for the easy layup.
Lost out of bounds by Pace right there on the baseline.
I mean, you got to understand this. Instead of throwing the lob, the bounce pass so he can finish at the rim. Good basketball, great IQ by Green.
Second assist of the game to go along with his 13 points and 6 of 10 shooting from the floor. Pace up 5, a chance to build on that now. Timeout called by the Knights with 11 seconds left in the first half. This is their largest lead of the game, so this is a great opportunity right here. Shot clock off. You can play for the final shot. Hit a two. Even if you get a three, you haven't hit one of those so far here in the first half. Get a two and take a 7-point lead into the locker room.
Well, here's the thing, you got to look at it. When Coach White saw that his top player was fatigued, let's call a 30-second timeout and get more rest. We want to get a good shot going into halftime. Instead of being up by 5, we got a chance to be up by 7. So that was a great timeout. Rest my players briefly, and let's get some strategy. We're going to take one shot to eliminate the heave by Fayette County. We don't want to charge. Guys, let's go out here, and let's go into the halftime with a lot of confidence.
.3 to work with on this final possession. Into the paint it goes. Spin move up and in. Kyle Green again at the buzzer and a 7-point lead. That was actually Chandler Bing that time with the basket. And a 7-point lead for Pace Academy as they head to the locker room. What a finish by the Knights as they outscore Fayette County 23-16 in that second quarter.
Well, Pace Academy is a well-coached team. His team, his players are disciplined, and it starts up front with Green.
7-point lead for the Knights. It's their largest lead of the game. They're heading to the locker room, and we're heading to Hannah Good.
Thank you, Matt. Coming up on the Halftime Show, we'll break down what's happened and what's to come on our DHSA Championship coverage, check in with John at Macon Coliseum, and hear from some special guests. It's all next right here on GBB Sports.
Best defense to stopping bugs and critters? That would be Breda Pest Management, protecting homes all over Georgia for nearly 50 years. See why so many homes are protected by Breda Pest Management at bredapest.com.
We continue our coverage of National Signing Day. We go now to Atlanta, Georgia for Kevin Connor's official declaration.
After giving it much thought, I've decided that next year I'll be going pro and building my skills as a Georgia plumber!
What impacted your decision?
It was an opportunity to earn money and learn on the job. I really love working with my hands, building things, and being part of a team.
Another highly touted prospect enters the trades.
Go Plumbers!
All right, what do you think, Jasper?
Honestly, I think that polyester shirt's faking your game.
What?
I think cotton would have been a better choice.
Cotton?
Yeah, it's come a long way, you know. Nowadays, cotton breathes and looks moisture great. Plus, buying cotton means supporting Georgia farmers. I think that's wonderful.
Okay, sure, but what do you think about the putt?
Oh, guess really hadn't thought about it.
I'm Hannah Gooden. We're live from the GBB Sports Studios in Atlanta. It's halftime of the GHSA 4A Boys Championship game between Fayette County and Pace Academy. Let's get you caught up on what's happened and what's to come on our GBB Championship scoreboard. So the game we're in right now has been a close one. Tigers are looking for their first state title ever, while Pace Academy won it all in 2021. Knights leading at the half 39-32. Earlier today at 1 o'clock, it was the single-A Division I girls title game. Clinch County took down the defending champs, Lake Oconee, 45-42 for the Panthers' first state title since 1993. Then at 3, it was the single-A Division II boys. Wilkinson County earned its 11th state championship, first since 2018 and first for head coach Xavier Whipple, with a 40-36 win over Charlton County. And at 5 o'clock, Quad A Griffin beat Baldwin for the region title and took down the Braves again for the 4A state girls title in the final seconds, 51-47. That was an outstanding game. So today is day one of four. We have a full week of basketball action and more to come here on the Halftime Show. We'll be right back with some special guests after this.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your face, got me feeling some kind of way.
Blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
As morning light signals the start of business, Georgia's Electric Membership Cooperatives are right there with you. Georgia's EMCs are a partner in economic development, serving commercial accounts big and small that drive Georgia's economy. From leading industries we rely on to local shops we treasure, we support operations on the ground, care around the clock, and growth through the seasons, lighting up good business. So business is good. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Welcome back. It's halftime of the GHSA 4A Boys Championship game between Fayette County and Pace Academy. Let's check in with John Nelson, who's standing by with the Tigers and Knights principals at Macon Coliseum.
It is time to catch up with folks and find out what's going on at Pace Academy and at Fayette County. And since I'm left-handed, Kat Monroe, the assistant AD at Pace Academy, won the toss. So we're going to come over here first. As a volleyball coach yourself, you've chased after titles. You know what it's like to be in the last match of the season, the last game of the year. When you see what Charm has been able to do in a very short period of time as a championship coach yourself, what's it been like to see that?
Wow. First and foremost, I feel like this season feels excruciatingly long when you go to the state playoffs, but every minute of it's worth it. And it's amazing to see Charmin back here after his 1920-2021 appearance here. And to, my office actually overlooks the gym, so I get to witness the day-to-day You know, Charmin at work and his coaching staff and the boys working hard. And that's just what I see, the discipline, the energy, the teamwork. I mean, he's all about his team. So it's exciting to be here. It's our spring break, so our audience is a little small but mighty, but we're here coming strong.
It's all good. Let's go to the flip side. Yolanda Briggs Johnson, the principal at Fayette County, and I have been given executive permission to call you YBJ.
That is correct.
What's it been like to see the student body and everyone embrace the chase for yet another championship at Fayette County?
Yes. So for us at the Fayette County High School.
The Fayette County High School.
That's right. It's been an adventure. This is our third time in 5 years. We seem to keep hitting the odd years. So there's always been momentum from 2019 to now. We have a huge following with our stakeholders, our community, our students certainly. But I think the biggest thing that I think I take away from watching and seeing how Coach Flynn has continued to develop amazing young men and players is we are a program.
No doubt about it.
We have a legacy at Fayette County High School.
And you are building that today.
Correct.
So, once again, great to catch up with our friends.
Thank you.
From Pace Academy, Kat Monroe, the assistant AD, YBJ, the principal at Fayette County. That's the story down here in Macon. Hannah, back to you in Atlanta.
Thanks, Sean. Always great to hear from the principals. We have to take one more quick break, but stick around for more right here on GPB Sports.
Hey, guys, it's time to reveal what I'm doing after graduation. We got my cupcakes and we got my schools. Let's just do it. Cupcakes aren't really my thing, and neither is going to a four-year college. Instead, I'm getting paid $18 an hour to train as a commercial plumber. There's a ton of other trades, like electrical and carpentry, where you can make great money, live a great lifestyle with little to no debt, and even be your own boss.
I've been checking food labels for years. I like to buy local, and I like to buy healthy for my family. So I started checking the labels on our clothes, too. Did you know synthetic fibers like polyester are pretty much made of oil? No thanks. I look for cotton now, which grows right here in Georgia, a major source of the world's cotton. Cotton is natural, renewable, sustainable, and buying cotton supports Georgia farmers. Good enough for me and my family.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your face, got me feeling some kind of way.
Of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Welcome back. Let's bring John Nelson back in, who is at Macon Coliseum, to get his thoughts on the first half. John, what have you seen from the Tigers versus Knights?
Interesting dichotomy. When you look at the shooting percentages, Fayette County shoots 50% in the first quarter, shoots only 33%, 4 of 12 in the second. Flip that for Pace Academy. Pace Academy seemed to get warm as the game went on. 7 of 17 in the first, 9 of 13 from the field in the second quarter. So will that hot hand continue for Pace Academy as we get to the third and the fourth? Sharm White and everybody who is following Pace Academy certainly hope so, Hannah.
And we'll send it over to the booth. Matt and Sean, second half of the Tigers and the Knights.
All right, thank you, Hannah. You know, you talked about that first quarter, and even though it was tied 16-16, you thought that Fayette County had won that quarter. Well, I think we all agree Pace Academy won that second quarter. Even though they're in foul trouble, they've done a good job of controlling the tempo and pace of this game.
Well, here's what you got to look at. You look at the way that Pace Academy plays. When it gets into their half court, it's not a one pass and done. They're moving the ball. They're getting high quality shots. That's a win for Pace Academy. Fayette County, they're coming out and they're trying to score the ball very quick. Now they get into the free throw line, which is huge, but now they got to defend in the half court. So it's kind of tug of war. Transition basketball, half court basketball. See which one prevails.
Yeah, it's been a fun watch, no doubt about that. Kyle Green, the master of running that offense for them, the four-star point guard, had himself a really good first half.
Listen, understand what this man does, this young man does. He has great size, great vision, strong IQ, and just right then getting to the rim. He'll get bigger, faster, and stronger. But here's more. Look at relentless on the basketball court, relentless on the rim, on the board. So, you know, it's huge for Pace, but here's the other guy coming in, and Fayette County really is doing a good job of just controlling the basketball, hitting the offensive glass, and then, you know, it's just going to be a seesaw battle here in the second half.
51% shooting for Pace in the first half, 41% for Fayette County. What else jumps out at you?
Rebounds, Pace Academy, 21-10. That's huge. But then points in the paint, Fayette County, 14, Pace Academy, 3.
So interesting first half. Pace Academy, 7-point lead as we get ready to start this third quarter. They are 16 minutes away from the fifth state championship in program history, the third under Coach Sharm White, and also on a personal note, it would be the 10th state championship for the legendary coach. Fayette County trying to break the been there, done that. They are 0-3 all time in state finals, including twice in the last 4 years. Turned over by Fayette County to start the third quarter. Chatfield on the wing. Underneath, offensive rebound, foul called on Fayette County.
Well, not a good series there for Fayette County. A quick turnover. Pace Academy comes down, gets the ball inside out, but they're relentless. They're getting second chance scoring opportunities. Now the tide has turned, and they're starting off the second half at the free throw line.
Van Dorn picks up his third personal foul, and Green make that Evans. Kendall Evans at the line hits the free throw. Evans. Now with 2 points in the game. And a 9-point lead for Pace Academy. Got to be careful here. These first 4 minutes of the third quarter could be big if Pace Academy can push this lead out into double digits.
Well, now if you're Fayette County, you got to keep attacking the rim. Don't panic and then stay positive because you can easily get your head down and now you create a double-digit game.
Pace on a 7-0 run going back to the end of the second quarter. And saved from going out of bounds. Nice move by Pace Academy. Green whips it to the baseline. Inside, shot rejected. And they stay with it and stick it up and in.
Could be an early timeout for Fayette County because now you've got an 11-point lead and, you know, you don't want your players to get down to themselves and need a positive injection, whether it's a drive to the basket or open shot. Something positive needs to happen real soon.
This game was tied at 32 late in the second quarter, but Pace Academy on an 11-0 run to open up an 11-point lead.
And here's what teams that play offensively fast, they don't understand how to play defensively fast or defensively in the half court. Great drive to the basket, and that's what you need. It's always good to score the ball when the clock is stopped. Give yourself a little breather, get your legs back, and now let's go ahead and get prepared to cut into this 11-point lead.
Kendall Evans was called for a second personal foul. Kennedy has only got 3 points in this game. They've done a good job of containing Fayette County's 24 points per game score.
I just love Green. Just his tempo, way to control, slow down, speed up. Man, this kid right here is very special. I love watching him play.
You and 20-plus schools around the country, some of the best have offered this young man.
Did you see what
and
just
he's
happened?
He's still just a junior. What
see
a pass.
How, oh, my gosh. Between the legs and the reverse way.
Up and in on the offensive glass.
And see, those Bing are the guys again. That we're talking about, Matt. You know, getting to the rim, scoring. Now the defense has to work. And now you see the frustration come in for Fayette County. Giving away open shots at the basket, turnovers. You know, it's a good timeout here so you can calm the team down.
Andre Flynn letting the officials hear about it. He's not happy. 45-32, Pace Academy pulling away early in this third quarter.
Every game day celebration, every championship title begins here with hours of unseen work. As part of our commitment to education, Georgia's EMC support the young athletes who play high school sports in the communities we serve. Empowering talent with scholarships, honoring sportsmanship, saluting the game changers. When we champion the energy behind the scenes, they can step into their future and shine. Georgia's EMCs, official energy provider of the GHSA.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
We continue our coverage of National Signing Day. We go now to Atlanta, Georgia for Kevin Connor's official declaration.
After giving it much thought, I've decided that next year I'll be going pro and building my skills as a Georgia plumber!
What impacted your decision?
It was an opportunity to earn money and learn on the job. I really love working with my hands, building things, and being part of a team.
Another highly touted prospect enters the trades.
Go plumber!
.45-32, that young man right now struggling through a difficult night, averages 24 a game, and R.J. Kennedy only 3 points, has not hit a field goal. All three of his points have come at the free throw line, Sean.
Well, you know, the reason is he's having to play a more complete game. It's not about his offense now. When you can outscore teams, that's one thing. But now you got to defend, that's a lot. So mentally, he's got to be able to balance his game out. I need to score, but I also need to defend.
He was a guy that was at the end of the bench the last time they played the state championship game last year, kind of in a secondary role, still a great season, but playing behind Caleb Banks, who's now at Indiana, but this year in a starring role as that lone senior who's a main contributor, and they need him to find a way to get involved in this offense and be a bigger factor if Fayette County is going to be able to make a run back and catch Pace Academy.
Well, Coach Flynn talked about how he has 11 underclassmen, and you've got this one senior out here trying to be the leader. You have got to carry a much larger load than just scoring. You have to defend. You have to rebound. So, you know, it's one of those things where your actions need to speak louder than your words, especially in a championship.
Layup up and in. Bing. Bing has really come to life here in this third quarter. He now has 10 points. .15 lead. It's all on a 15-0 run for Pace dating back to the 1:19 mark in the second quarter. That's the last time Fayette County hit a field goal.
And, you know, you talk about coaching, and, you know, we talk about Green here, and I get back to the coaching thing. Look, he dissects the off the defense. It's a nice old-school scoop. Man, this kid right here is going to be really, really good. But on the defensive end, what Pace is doing, they're finding ways to trap the ball to force a turnover. Sometimes they jump the ball when it crosses half court. They're trapping in the corner. And that's Coach White kind of pulling out that knowledge and wisdom that he's gained from coaching on the national circuit.
Missed by L.J. Moore. And I apologize, I misidentified that last basket. Said it was Bing and Kyle Green. Full transparency, it's hard to read white on white numbers. It just is. I'm sure the uniforms look great, but they don't help out the announcers and the fans trying to watch the game at home.
Well, listen, man, when you get older, we're getting older, eyes are getting a little weaker, huh?
I don't know that my eyes were ever that good. Chatfield is called for the foul.
And see, this is a make-or-break moment for Fayette County. You know, even though it's a 15-point game, you can cut it down to 10 going into the fourth quarter. You just got to be consistent and stay positive. You can't have negative plays, a negative mindset, negative body language.
Saw Davis Rice just check into the game, the jumper. Offensive, defensive rebound control by Pace. Ahead comes the Rice. Had a shot blocked by Kennedy, who got back on defense. And then he steals it away. Stolen away by Gillespie. The step through, Kennedy gets fouled, he'll go to the line. And this is a big part of Kennedy's game is getting to the line. He leads the team in free throw makes and free throw attempts, and he'll be headed back to the line again.
Just got to be a little bit more aggressive here in the second half. No attack when opportunity presents itself, but he's got to be more of that go-to guy. Take a sense of ownership. Guys, I got you. Let's get back in this game, but it's got to be one possession at a time.
Madison back in the game, and that ends the long drought for Fayette County as Kennedy continues to score at the free throw line. He's got 4 points, all of them at the stripe.
And see, that's what happens. When you're down by 14 points, you start thinking about negative things. And you can't allow that to happen because it affects your game, not just offensively, but defensively as well.
Well, at one point, Fayette County was 8 of 10 at the foul line. They've now missed 5 of their last 9 attempts, so they're 12 for 19 in the game.
Well, Pace Academy made an adjustment. They started to, let's apply some pressure, maybe this full court 2-2-1 or in the half court, but in the half court, offensively, we're going to run our stuff. We need the ball to be reversed 1, 2, maybe 3 times and force Fayette County to fatigue on the defensive end.
Foul called on Pace. Reach-in foul. Madison picks up the foul. That's going to be number 3 on him. MJ Madison, a 6'5", 175-pound freshman. And Fayette County just got warning on the bench. Andre Flynn's been letting the officials hear it for a while now. Frustrated with the way the game is going. Van Dorn at the elbow. Right up the middle. They give it to Green. He keeps the ball moving really quick. Pace does a good job of sharing. Kennedy, first basket of the game for RJ Kennedy.
And he penetrated under control. He didn't try to force it. Came to a complete jump stop and hit the ball off the glass. And, you know, if you're Kennedy, you understand, you're not going to score in bunches. Take your time and just understand. Be patient and shoot the basket. Now, coach is fair. That was a foul. Wasn't called. So he calls a timeout. Guys, now we're going to set our press ups. 12-point game. We're fine. We're okay. Let's just take it one possession at a time.
Maybe that basket right there for RJ Kennedy gets him going. He realizes there's a lot on his shoulders as the senior on this team. One of the reasons why Coach Flynn told us this was a surprise team for them because he was the only senior they had coming back in a starring role. And Kennedy has been able to carry them this year to a 26-5 record.
And you can tell he has a knack for the game. He knows how to score the game. But now he has to use energy offensively, but now defensively as well, too. So when you get the ball, don't force it. When the opportunity opens up, attack, score, and get back on defense.
Fayette County went 6 minutes and 52 seconds between baskets. That's why the game went from tied to down 12.
And see now, you see Kennedy, you get a couple of baskets, what happens? The defense picks up.
He's putting out maximum effort. He's getting it done on both ends of the floor, working really hard. Elbow, raise the iron, Pace gets the offensive rebound, and Rice sticks it up and in.
And that's just a hustle play. You know, Rice comes in and, you know, just gets that good hustle rebound and finishes at the rim.
12 offensive rebounds for Pace in this game. Stolen away and foul called on Pace. Maybe a little bit of a spark here for Fayette County as Evans is whistled for the foul. And that's going to put Hurst at the line.
Whenever the post players get the ball, you have to get a quick outlet. You know, those guards come in, I mean, they're going to attack the ball, especially a weak guy that really doesn't understand how to dribble outside of the trap. So that was great defense for Fayette County during that time.
Hurst, the other senior in the lineup, 6.3 points per game. converts on both of them, and they've cut the lead to 12.
So here's the pressure. And how does Pace handle it? I think this is a great defensive possession opportunity for Fayette County. Let's create some turnovers. Let's, you know, create some faster pace. But Academy, Pace Academy has to come out and extend the ball. So, you know, that's Coach Flynn doing it. Guys, we got to press early. Not until the fourth quarter. Press early. And this is a timeout opportunity and for Coach White to talk to his team. And they've got to handle the press better.
Well, the full court pressure forced an immediate traveling violation. So you can see when Fayette County is able to get into their press, jump into their press, it changes the dynamic of their team.
Well, if you watch Coach White, he's pointing at his mind. Guys, let's think. Slow down. Let's think. Be calm. Stay under control. Coach Flynn, he's telling his guys, stay in attack mode. Don't foul, but stay in attack mode. We're going to put them on the back of their heels. We're going to get turnovers, but we got to be smart when we go for the ball.
So Fayette County now can get this lead down to 10, perhaps even 9 if they can hit a 3. They're just 1-for-7 on their threes. How about this, Sean? These two teams are combined 1-for-11 on three-point shots. Only one three-pointer made between these two teams.
Yeah, three-point shooting definitely isn't the strength of either two, but attacking the rim definitely is.
Kennedy bounces inside, and a foul called on Pace again. Again, staying in attack mode. They'll be going to the line, and Hurst will be right back on that stripe again.
And see, the action, what started at the beginning of the game, is what Fayette County's doing. Attacking the rim, under control, and getting at the free throw line.
So Green is called for the foul. That's going to be number 2 on him. And 6 team fouls now on Pace Academy. The next one puts him over the limit. And you might remember back to the first half, it was when Pace got in early foul trouble. And Fayette County was able to take advantage of that, get to the line, and get some easy points that they were able to hang with Pace Academy.
And that's what the formula you have to get back to if you're Fayette County. Attack, get to the free throw line, and one thing, score when the clock is stopped.
Got a good chance to do that. Pace now has 6 team fouls. Fayette County has only 1. Lead is under double digits for the first time in a while. Van Dorn clears the rebound. Stolen away. Moore in the paint. Left it short. Moore has not scored in this quarter, but they clean up underneath.
Yeah, chip shot layup. But you can tell, if you look at Pace Academy, the way they're playing, they're starting to look fatigued. They're making turnovers, uncareless turnovers. They're shooting air balls. One of the things that Fayette County, once you see that, now you have to be a little bit more vicious on your defense.
It's really, it's about the offensive rebounds. They're getting so many opportunities, second chance opportunities. And they have outscored Fayette County 18-8 on second chance opportunities. That's about the difference in the game right now. You see the 14 offensive boards compared to only 5 offensive rebounds for Fayette County.
But when you're a pressing team, you can defend the perimeter, but you cannot defend the paint because you're so spaced out. And that's what you give up. We'll give up the second chance shot because we're spaced out on the court trying to get deflections and steals.
Hurst is called for the foul. He was surprised by it. That's number 4 on him, and he'll go take a seat on the bench. Evans gets in the paint, steps in, puts it in with the left hand.
Great isolation move right there. Getting to the basket, finishing with the left hand. And you know, this kid right here, Evans, is starting to pick up, and great, nice body, great finish, good hands, and but you got to defend on the opposite end as well.
Starting to pick up, that's RJ Kennedy. Kennedy now with 8 points. Pace Academy calls timeout with 54 seconds left here in the third quarter.
Good penetration. RJ getting to the rim with the scoop. And that's how he plays. He's got to stay in attack mode for them to make a move here going into the fourth quarter.
Kennedy, 8 points now, 8 of their 40. And along with Ijiwoye, he has 8. And Hurst, actually their leading scorer with 9, is now on the bench with 4 personal fouls. L.J. Moore, who scored 17 in the first half, has not scored here in the third quarter. Kyle Green has 15. Those are the two Pace Academy players in double figures. They've started to get more contributions. Remember, at one point, they had scored 28. That combo of Green and Moore had combined for 28 of the 30. Now it's just 32 of their 53. Pace Academy, their road to the final after losing their region championship game and going into the playoffs as a 2 seed. They routed Miller Grove, Coach Sharm White's former team, 1 on the road at Walnut Grove, 1 on the road at Baldwin, and then 1 in the semifinals against Westover. But yeah, they had to play 2 road games on the way and a neutral site game because they didn't win their region championship. They got upset by Lovett. Coach Sharm White called it a self-inflicted wound. So they went into the playoffs as a 2 seed. Step through, nicely done. Soft hands.
Well, the patience offensively, just the patience. That's Moore just slowing down in the paint and took his time. He didn't force the play. He allowed the action to come to him. And that's actually smart basketball on his behalf.
First field goal of the second half for L.J. Moore. He has 19. Shot clock off, playing down to the final shot, 8 seconds. Kennedy in the paint, and they're going to call a jump ball. And the possession arrow is going to belong to Fayette County. So they retain possession with 6.3 seconds left in the third quarter.
And plays like that offensively, you use a lot of energy. You don't even get a chance to attempt the shot because of the jump ball.
Inbounds, nicely done. A big basket right at the end of the third quarter as they found Kennedy right underneath. And a 13-point lead for Pace as we head to the fourth. 55-42 after 3 quarters of play in Macon.
While we have a quick break from the action, did you know that the same area of just one basketball court can contain thousands of termites? That's why you need the expertise of Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school basketball.
Let me know if I can help you with anything.
Just looking. I only buy local and sustainable, so.
Oh, well, that shirt's not local. You should be wearing cotton. Georgia's a major supplier of cotton worldwide, so if you'd like to buy local to support Georgia, buying cotton's a great place to start. It's renewable and sustainable, naturally.
Thanks.
And that's a polyester fiber made of oil, by the way.
Where's your dressing room?
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your face, got me feeling so good.
In the blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Half of the nation's opioid overdoses happen right at home because people don't understand the dangers of taking an Oxy or Perc with a glass of alcohol for stress or to sleep. Learn how to protect your family from opioid overdose at opioidresponse.info.
Start of the fourth quarter in Macon, the 4A state championship game. Pace Academy outscoring Fayette County 16-10 in that third quarter, and they lead by 13. Full schedule tomorrow. We start at 1 with the Class 2A state title game in the girls bracket, Mount Perrin versus Banks County. Then the 2A boys, Westside Augusta taking on Providence Christian. We'll have the co-ed three-point shootout. Class 5A girls at 5:30, Kell versus Warner Robins. An all-state player, Crystal Henderson, starring for the Longhorns, and then we'll have the 5A state championship game in the boys' bracket as Kell takes on Eagles Landing, the two teams, Sean, that have been ranked 1-2 in 5A all season long.
Well, tomorrow it's going to be a huge day, but tonight I think we're going to have an exciting fourth quarter. You know, Pace Academy, here's what you have to do. Attack the press under control, but don't foul. You have to play without fouling. Fayette County, on the other end, don't get frustrated. Still, we've got almost 8 minutes to go. Don't get frustrated by the score, one possession at a time.
In the paint, we'll have a traveling call on Bing. So that's a start for Fayette County if they're going to make the climb back in this thing. And the silver lining for the Tigers, who went nearly 7 minutes from the back end of the second quarter into the third quarter without a field goal. They hit their last three field goals of the third quarter to get within striking distance here in the fourth.
But it's one thing to score, but you not just can't score. You got to get defense and stops as well.
Kennedy in the paint feeds to Ejiwoye. And he missed up close. They'll call a jump ball, and it's going to be Pace's ball. Toby Ejiwoye has been a big spark for this Tigers team. Did not start, and it's going to be Fayette's ball. I thought Fayette got it the last time. Inbounds comes to Van Dorn. Van Dorn off the iron.
And see, the Pace Academy, they're defending, but they're defending the shot. Defend the player. But they're doing a great job of holding their ground. We're not going to contest it. Just make it hard and tough for you to score the ball in the paint.
Moore goes all the way right through the defense and missed the layup. Back the other way. The alley-oop. Kennedy couldn't finish. Feeds underneath. Foul called on Pace. And that'll send the Tigers to the line. And Christian McAllister.
Now, the way you get back into a game like this is score while the ball, while the clock is stopped. You know, you don't have to score when the ball is, when the clock is running. You can get to the free throw line, get a breather. Now you can set your press, and now you've got a 12-point game, possibly an 11, and then Fayette County can come in, set up the press, and see what they can get, some easy steals and baskets.
And that foul on Moore put Pace Academy over the limit, so Fayette County is going to be shooting bonus for this entire quarter.
Now here's the press. What do you pass over the top? Attack to score, but you don't attack to just get it over.
I agree with Coach Flynn. I thought he traveled. Chatfield scoops up, foul call, Fayette County. And Chatfield might be hurt. He's slow getting up. Kennedy is called for the foul right here.
I think that was an off-balance shot, but it happens. It happens.
That's a tough one.
Now, here's a defensive thing that you're not paying attention to, and we'll see it. What Fayette County is doing, they're in full denial on Green. They're going face guarding on Green. They're going to make everyone else win the game and see if they can take Green out of the equation.
Chatfield is an 84% free throw shooter. That was just his third point of the night. They've all come at the foul line. He's 3 for 3.
Well, he's got to step up here in the fourth quarter for Pace Academy to cut down the nets.
Got only one of the two. It's a 12-point game as Fayette County comes across into their offense. Kennedy gets a high ball screen, goes the other way, in traffic, gets fouled.
And see, all that's by design. Use the ball screen to get the mismatch, get the, you know, what you need, what you want, and then that's attack. Attack down rim, downhill, and get to the free throw line.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, get to the free throw line, just keep attacking the basket. Christian Bing picks up his fourth personal, and Kennedy misses the free throw.
And that's called fatigue. Remember what I said. It's one thing to be an aggressive scorer, but when you have to score and defend, your body, that takes a toll on your body.
He's now 4 for 9 at the free throw line. He's a better free throw shooter than that. 69% this season. But you're right, he has had to expend a lot of energy on both ends of the floor. Missed them both. They cannot afford to do that here in this game if they're going to get back in it.
Hearing Coach White, hey guys, it's cut. Let's move. We need movement now.
Lost the dribble, saved by Ferry. Chatfield hits the runner. First basket for Eric Chatfield.
And Coach White talked about it. He's got two-headed point guard situation, and Chatfield this quarter has to step up because Green is getting face guarded and it's been tough for him to make plays.
Right there in the middle, Van Dorn has to give it up. McAllister on the dribble, goes left side, shot blocked, foul call. Looked like LJ Moore got a clean block, so it must be on a reach in. Yeah, Kendall Evans picks up his fourth. So now you have Bing and Evans with four personal fouls. Evans was riding his body down the left side of the lane. So McAllister foul line hits the free throw. He's 73% at the foul line.
You know, a lot of times in this situation, coaches would go to a zone and force Fayette County to play on the perimeter. But one thing about the zone, you also give up the rebounding. So what you do is play a softer man-to-man, but still you got to rebound the basketball if you pace Academy.
Even with that miss, Fayette County has five more makes on free throws than Pace Academy has attempted. I would not guess that they'd be down 13 with that in mind. 46 of the 58 have come in the paint. They're 0 for 4 on threes. Again, the attack by Chatfield, capped from behind. Shot clock. It shouldn't have reset.
Hit the rim. It did hit the rim.
It hit the rim. I thought it hit the backboard. And we'll have a timeout with an even 5 minutes left in regulation. Pace Academy gunning for their fifth state title. They're up 13.
In lively towns and peaceful rural areas, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives are on a mission to provide a different kind of electricity. Our not-for-profit, member-owned EMCs are focused on making life better for members. At private residences, farms, and thriving businesses, we work for you. Generating safe, reliable, affordable electricity, giving back to local programs, serving our members to make life brighter. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
It's time to reveal what I'm doing after graduation. We got my cupcakes and we got my schools. Let's just do it. Cupcakes aren't really my thing, and neither is going to a four-year college. Instead, I'm getting paid $18 an hour to train as a commercial plumber. There's a ton of other trades, like electrical and carpentry, where you can make great money, live a great lifestyle with little to no debt, and even be your own boss.
Five minutes left. Only 3 points total for each team scored in this quarter so far. Match to along with Sean Golden. Stick around. Player of the game, an interview with the coach of the championship team coming up with John Nelson before we cap our evening here on day one of the Georgia High School Association State Basketball Championship. So happy that the games are back on GPB. We've been thrilled and counting down the days, and now it's here. We got three more to go. Four more games each of the next 3 days.
There's a word that you think about in a game like this is called fatigue. Both teams are tired because not only have they have to play good offense, they both have had to play good defense as well. And that's very hard to do. And the emotions that surround a championship game, that adds to the tired mountain, as we call it as players.
Now, they started the clock. They should not have started the clock. The clock should not have started until he touched the ball, which he did not do until it reached half court. So they should put 5 back on the clock or 4:59 or something of that nature, which leads me to another subject. I'm not a big fan of the roll the ball in and wait to pick it up.
Understandable.
I mean, I get it. Your clock doesn't start. I get the concept behind it, but just pick it up and get to the front court quicker, right?
Yes and no. And the reason why is if the team is not going to extend the defense, take advantage of what they give you. You know, you look at the NBA, the clock doesn't start. It's 24-second shot clock doesn't start until you pick the ball up.
Right.
So get it to half court. Now you just added possibly 6 minutes to your offense, 6 seconds, excuse me, and now the defense has to defend a little bit longer in the half court.
You make a compelling argument, Coach Sean Golden. So they fixed the shot clock, but I think you got to go back to 4:59.
Correct.
You can't. There it is. They fixed it.
It's Wilt.
So they're still trying to figure it out. I think they've got it right. So there you go. They inbounds the ball. They lost 1 second. And they got it in the front court. They nearly throw it away, and they do.
And see, coaching. You know, RJ gets the ball, comes off the ball screen. What happens? Trap. And that's a scouting report thing. Don't let him isolate on the ball screen. Trap the ball, force him to pass it out, and then deny him on the return. And forced a turnover there, and that's great coaching and scouting report there by Coach White and the staff.
What a job that Andre Flynn has done with this Fayette County program, though. 22 years ago when he took over the program, the team had gone 2-22 the year before, and he's made the playoffs every single year that he has been there. Big jumper there by Kyle Green. That gives him 17 in this game.
Well, that was his shot. 15 feet and in, elevate over the defense, nice and smooth and under control.
Corner three, we still had only 1 3-point make in this game. And a 3-second violation on Fayette County. You can tell the officials are not Coach Flynn's favorite people.
Well, when you're down by 15 points, no one is, because you're frustrated. Why is my team in this situation, and what can we do to cut into this league? And every time they try to make a play, Pace County comes back, Pace Academy comes back to make a big-time play.
L.J. Moore puts it on the floor, spin move to get in the paint, running clock, shot clock down to 9 now. Chatfield goes around the screen, gets it back to Moore. Nicely done.
That's patience. That's coaching. That's patience. That's great court awareness and not rushing the action.
Back the other way, and the basket by Hurst. So they get the two back very quickly, but we're now down to 3.5 to go and a 15-point lead for Pace.
Nice drive to the rim. And that's the way that Fayette County has to cut into this lead. It's not going to be shooting threes. Continue to keep tacking the rim and scoring while the clock is off.
Hurst has been their leading scorer tonight. He has 12. He's doubled up his per-game average of 6 a game. But down 14 now, time running short for Fayette County.
And see, there's the ISO. Now letting Green get the ball back.
Attacking the basket. Pass in the paint. Moore gets the offensive glass, gets tied up. Looks like they're going to call a foul, not a jump ball. And the foul's going to go against Fayette County and Isaiah Franklin.
Well,
second
who's
on
getting
him.
A rebound? Who's getting a rebound? Moore. I mean, the guy is scoring. He's defending. He's rebounding. They talk about being Mr. Versatile. He's doing it all tonight.
40 rebounds for Pace Academy in this game to Fayette County, 17. 17 offensive rebounds for Pace. So they have as many offensive rebounds as Fayette County has total rebounds, and one. And that might be the clincher right there as Moore goes over 20 points in this game with a fabulous spin move.
Just a young man, relentless, playing strong, aggressive, finishing with two hands, and just has a strong motor and a will to win. And, you know, players like that, you got to have them on your team to win the championship.
6'7", 185 junior forward, and he has just been phenomenal tonight. 23 points, 7 rebounds, 10 of 15 shooting from the floor, and just doing a workmanlike effort on the glass. Kennedy gets in there, lost it. Run out opportunity for Pace. Chatfield back underneath, and the layup. Kyle King now with 19.
You know, Chatfield, great court awareness, and Green knowing where to be at the right place at the right time. And you know, now they're coming back to a zone, matchup zone, to try to control the tempo just a little bit more and keeping Fayette County out of the paint.
Now reality is starting to set in for Fayette County as they are down 18 with 2:17 to go. And it looks like there's going to be very little they can do to prevent Pace Academy from winning their fifth state championship, the third under Sharm White. And how about Sharm White, his 10th state championship, now just 2 minutes and 17 seconds away. What a performance by Pace tonight on the big stage.
All right, what do you think, Jasper?
Honestly, I think that polyester shirt's affecting your game.
What?
I think cotton would have been a better choice.
Cotton?
Yeah, it's come a long way, you know. Nowadays, cotton breathes and looks moisture great. Plus, buying cotton means supporting Georgia farmers. I think that's wonderful.
Okay, sure, but what do you think about the putt?
Oh, just really hadn't thought about it.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your face got me feeling some kind of way.
Of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Today's conservation-minded consumer cares about where their energy comes from. Your local EMC cares too. Georgia's electric membership cooperatives offer renewable options for our members. In fact, our solar portfolio will produce enough clean energy to power more than 180,000 households. Striving to move the needle toward progress and position communities for the future. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
Back in Macon for the final 2+ minutes of this 4A state championship game. Pace Academy ranked number one in 4A now with an 18-point lead on the third-ranked Fayette County Tigers. And they've done it by outscoring Fayette County 27-16 here in this second half.
Well, there's a system. There's a method to the madness. There's a method to the success of Coach White and his staff. Guys, we got to work hard, not just on the court, off the court. And trust me, he's built trust in his team. He's built trust in the players. He's built trust in the community. And that's why he wins at every level.
That was a second three-pointer by Gillespie. He has the only 2 3-pointers in this game. And it's going to be too little, too late for Fayette County. Pace Academy running clock. Shot clock down to 7. And did they call a timeout or a foul?
Timeout.
Looked like a timeout call with 5 seconds on the shot clock.
And see, you see Coach White coaching again. Hey, you don't pick the ball up right here on the sideline. You got to space it, pass, fake, move it around. Guys got to cut. And that's how you win championships. Now you're preparing these guys. Late game situation, time and score, and let's still continue to stay focused and finish strong.
Charmin White getting ready to enter into very rare company with a 10th state championship. It'll be his third at Pace after winning 7 at Miller Grove. He won 6 in a row at Miller Grove at one point, was there for 11 seasons, jumped out of the high school game for a couple of years, was on Ron Hunter's staff at Georgia State for a couple of seasons, but then got back into the high school game.
Yeah, he and I talked about that. And, you know, his bread and butter, his heart is at this level because you can change lives. You can change lives just not on the court, but off the court. You can embrace the community. He's a guy that loves the community. He's a strong family man. And that's why he wins. He is the ultimate package of a coach and a guy that can be the head of the ship.
Offensive rebound, another one. They have just killed them on the offensive glass tonight. Fayette County trying to do their best to force a turnover without fouling. Shot clock down to 5. Going to have to do something with it. Chatfield got fouled on the shot attempt.
And on Fayette County's behalf, listen, they got here to the championship game. They've got 11 underclassmen. No, RJ is, you know, he tried to do the best he could tonight, but you know, look at Pace Academy, they were just too much. They moved the ball offensively. They made Fayette County defend in the half court and in the full court. And fatigue, the team that wanted to play fast, I think fatigue cut out to them.
Yeah, they really did a good job of making R.J. Kennedy work both ends of the floor. He's going to finish with 8 tonight, or thereabouts, 16 below his per-game average. Down to our final 50 seconds, now less than that to go. Gillespie hits another 3, gives him 3 in the game, 94 on the season. Lead down to 12, but clock's going to run out on him. A foul called on Fayette County, the shot clock off.
And that's a frustration foul, which is understandable. Young team from Fayette County, this is one of those games that when you're underclassmen in this situation, you don't get frustrated, you don't get upset. Allow the emotions that you feel tonight. You feel those same emotions when it comes into spring workouts, summer workouts, so you can get this back and possibly be in a position to cut down nets next season.
Coach White gives his stars, Moore and Green, a chance to come off and take a bow. They combine for 42 of Pace's 66 points tonight. That's going to do it. They're going to dribble it out. And Pace Academy has won their 5th state championship, their 3rd in 4 seasons under head coach Charm White, who hits the decade mark with his 10th state championship. 66-54 the final. Fayette County a fine season, but for the 4th time in Coach Andre Flynn's 22 years as the head coach, they come up short in the championship game.
Whenever you win a championship at any level, it's a great feeling. But whenever you win 10, well, this kudos to Coach Flynn and his staff. You had a young team, and they'll be back. Fayette County will be back. But Coach White just doing what he does best, coaching his team, teaching them how to be successful, and doing it in a way that This was not a close win. They dominated this game. A game they were supposed to possibly lose in a lot of people's minds.
Yeah, at one point it was 32-32, and Pace Academy outscores Fayette County 34-22 the rest of the way to win this game. And let's send it down to John Nelson.
Thank you very much, Matt Stewart. Time to give away the last trophy of day number one here for the 2023 championships. And to do it, first off, it is the second place trophy with our friends at Fayette County. And to do it, it's the executive director of the Georgia High School Association, Dr. Robin Hine.
Coach, I want to congratulate you on a great season. You and your players were just awesome. I want to thank all of your fans that came out to support you. And it's a great pleasure to give you this state runner-up trophy.
Thank
congratulations.
You very much. I appreciate it. Thank
all
you.
Right.
Thank you.
Which means it is time to give away the championship trophy. And to someone who has got a few in his career, Sharm White and Pace Academy champs once again here in the state of Georgia. Once again, the executive director of the Georgia High School Association, Dr. Robin Hines.
Coach, there you are. Congratulations, Pace Academy, state champions. Coach, I want to give you an opportunity to say what this means to you, your players, and your fans.
First of all, I got to give glory to God for giving me this assignment and trusting me with the assignment. Secondly, I want to thank my family, my wife and my kids, my mom and dad, my siblings. And then I want to thank the Pace community. They have really embraced this team. This team wasn't expected to do this year. We were a year early, but we took advantage and we seized the day. And then I want to also be able to thank these players. They bought in, they did everything they had to, the coaches, players, everybody. It's just a great culture and a great program that we have at Miller Grove, and we're gonna continue to be here. I'm Pace Academy!
And so, we'll catch up with Coach Sharm White and LJ Moore coming up in just a little bit. Let's send it back to Atlanta.
Yeah, what a great run by Pace Academy. And both those coaches, very gracious. Coach Flynn in defeat and Coach Sharm White in victory.
At the high school level, a lot of coaches have two options. Number one, do you build a team or do you build a program? And that's what Coach White does. Wherever he goes, he's focusing on building a program.
We'll step aside, and when we come back, we'll hear from Coach Sharm White and the star of the game, LJ Moore, when we continue from Macon.
The best defense to stopping bugs and critters? That would be Breda Pest Management, protecting homes all over Georgia for nearly 50 years. See why so many homes are protected by Breda Pest Management at BREDAPest.com.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
We continue our coverage of National Signing Day. We go now to Atlanta, Georgia for Kevin Connor's official declaration.
After giving it much thought, I've decided that next year I'll be going pro and building my skills as a Georgia plumber!
What impacted your decision?
It was an opportunity to earn money and learn on the job. I really love working with my hands, building things, and being part of a team.
Another highly touted prospect enters the trades.
Go Plumbers!
Welcome back to the Macon Coliseum and the Macon Centerplex as we put a bow on day number one for the 2023 Dr. Ralph Swearingen GHSA High School Basketball Championships. And it's time to catch up with the winners from game number four, player of the game, LJ Moore. And we know Sharm. We'll catch up with Sharm in just a little bit. So let's come over here. What was the message at halftime? Because it was a tight game going up against this team. What was the message? What was the conversations at half?
It was just to defend, because we know this is a high-powered offense. They averaged 76 points a game. We knew we couldn't let them put up 76 against us in order to win this game.
What's it been like to travel the planet and actually have to use your passport to play games this year? What's it been like with this ride?
I would just say it's a blessing to be able to travel all over the world. Not everybody can do this, so I just thank God for allowing me to be able to do that.
All right, so Coach said you were a year early, huh? No pressure, eh?
Yeah, no pressure.
Has it sunk in that you're a champ holding that basketball there?
No, it hasn't sunk in yet. There's still a whole lot of emotions going on.
Okay, well, enjoy those emotions. All right, go celebrate with your team. We're going to come over here and catch up with Charm. As I said, you've done this before. And by the way, our interviews, all of our coach interviews, sponsored by our friends at Breda Pest Management, the official sponsor of high school basketball. Let me ask you this. Do you remember what it was like to win your first one, much less your 10th?
You know what? I do, but I have a, you know, a bad memory when it comes to days like this because I try to treat each one just like it's the most important one. And we didn't take no, you know, days off from preparation, trying to get ready for a really, really good team in Fayette County. And, you know, I don't take these moments for granted, and I try to make sure our guys don't, because it's not always guaranteed that you'll get here every year. And we've just been fortunate, and I've been fortunate as a coach to be able to get here quite a few times.
What's it been like to build this program knowing that that a nation is chasing after you at times with that bullseye on? What's it been like to build this program 3 and 4 years?
It's been fun, man. You know, when I got there, they were very receptive to the things I wanted to do to make sure this program is synonymous with one of the top programs, not only in the state, but in the country. And, you know, the Pace community has, you know, just welcomed me, and I couldn't be more happier at a place that really cares about not only, you know, the athletics and all that, but they care about people. And I think that's the most important part. They care about people.
You put the pedal down in the third quarter. What was the difference?
We knew we had to defend. We had not defended the way we were capable of defending the first two quarters. We gave up 32 points, and we knew that if we put our foot down and defended, we knew we were going to have a really good chance of winning this game. And our guys did that. They did that. They know we can defend better than we had shown, and I was just proud of them for stepping up to the challenge that I gave them at halftime.
You've got your hands in your pockets. If you were to take your hands out of your pockets, there would be a ring for each championship on each of those fingers. You can go ahead and put your hands back in your pocket. Congratulations on winning another state championship. Great to see you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thanks, GPBB, for bringing the basketball championships back on TV. We really appreciate it.
Thank you much. That's the story from day one. He's Charm. He's a champ. Let's send it back to two more champs in Atlanta.
All right. Thank you.